Hey there. In this video, I'll explain everything you need to know about pod networking for Kubernetes on AWS. There's a few different ways you can set up your pod networking. I'll walk you through the differences and why you might choose one versus another for both self-managed clusters and Amazon's managed Kubernetes service, EKS. So let's start with a couple of Kubernetes nodes. The EC2 instances they are running on both have ETH0 network interfaces, which connect them to the underlying AWS network. Under the covers, each instance has an Elastic Network Interface, ENI, configured with the node's IP address. AWS Networking handles the rest for you. The pods running on each of the nodes also have IP addresses. These are usually allocated from the Kubernetes PodSider IP address range. Each pod has its own networking environment isolated from the host using Linux network namespaces. With Calico, the pods are connected to the host using a pair of virtual Ethernet interfaces, often referred to as a VETH pair. The pods see ETH0 as their interface, and the host has an algorithmically generated interface name beginning with Cali. To connect these virtual interfaces together, Calico essentially sets up the host networking namespace so that each of the nodes acts as a virtual router. The local pods are connected to the virtual router, and Calico makes sure the virtual router knows where all the pods are across the rest of the cluster, so it can forward traffic to the right places. All the traffic forwarding happens natively within the Linux kernel through code paths that have been highly optimized over many years, so the simplicity of this setup pays off in terms of performance. However, the AWS networking only knows the ENI IP addresses and knows nothing about where the pods are. So if a pod on one node tries to send traffic to a pod on another node, it will get routed out of ETH0 to the AWS network. But then AWS networking doesn't know where to send the packet because it's not aware of the pod IP addresses at all. The traditional way of solving this challenge is to use an overlay network. Calico supports both VXLAN and IPIP overlays, implemented as virtual interfaces within the Linux kernel. When a pod sends a packet to a pod on a different node, the original packet is encapsulated using VXLAN or IPIP into an outer packet, using the node IP addresses and hiding the pod IPs from the original inner packet. AWS networking handles this just like any other node-to-node traffic. On the receiving node, the VXLAN or IPIP packet is de-encapsulated to reveal the original packet, which is then delivered to the destination pod. This is all done in the Linux kernel, so it's about as efficient as it can be, but it still represents an overhead which you might want to avoid if you're running network-intensive workloads. The good news is that with Calico, you can avoid the need for an overlay if your nodes are running within a single VPC subnet. AWS has an ENI setting called Disable Source Desk Check, which was designed for connecting virtual routers or other virtual networking equipment. This allows Calico to send pod-to-pod traffic across the AWS network without using an overlay, so long as it's within a single VPC subnet. This is great for performance, but if the cluster is split across multiple VPC subnets, for example, to be spread across AWS availability zones, then the AWS routers between the subnets, which are not pod aware, will still not know how to handle the packets. Which means pod-to-pod traffic between nodes in different subnets needs to go over the overlay. Calico is smart though, so pod-to-pod traffic between nodes within the same subnet still goes unencapsulated without using the overlay. So you'll always get the best achievable performance for every packet, only using overlay for packets where it's really needed. And with Calico's excellent scaling characteristics, your pod network will scale up to the limits of Kubernetes if you need it to. Another approach to avoiding overlays is to use the Amazon VPC CNI plugin. This comes by default with EKS, and you can also use it with your own self-managed clusters. The way it sets up Linux networking is similar to Calico, but with a few small differences. There's a trivial difference that the host side of the pod VETH pair names start with ENI rather than Cali. More significantly, the pods are allocated IP addresses from the underlying VPC subnet, and the pod IPs are configured as secondary IPs on the instance's ENIs. If the number of pods on a node exceeds the number of secondary IPs supported by the ENI, then additional ENIs will be allocated for the node automatically. The Linux routing table is programmed to route traffic to and from a particular pod via the ENI associated with the pod's IP. So if pod A connects to pod C, the traffic gets routed via E0 on node 1. If pod B connects to pod E, the traffic gets routed via ETH1 on node 1. And because AWS networking is already aware of the pod IPs, it can route across VPC subnet boundaries without the need for an overlay. It's important to note that it's the EC2 instance size that determines the maximum number of pods that can be supported on a particular node. For example, an M5 large instance supports 27 pods, whereas an M5 2x large supports 56 pods. In addition, by default, the pod IPs come from your VPC subnet, which at scale may lead to IP address range exhaustion challenges. You can configure the plugin to use a separate subnet for pods, but at the cost of losing one ENI per node, which in turn reduces the number of pods supported on each node. As a final option, Flannel can also provide a VXLAN overlay for AWS, but note it has a slightly more complicated data path that is less efficient than Calico's implementation. Whichever choice you make for networking, including EKS, Calico provides network policy enforcement so you can secure your workloads. You can think of this as putting a virtual firewall in front of every pod that is dynamically configured in real time based on the Kubernetes and Calico network policies you have defined. It makes it incredibly easy to lock down your pod network so the only traffic that is allowed to flow is the traffic you are expecting to flow. That's all for now. I hope you found this quick video useful, and thanks for watching.